Hey everyone, it's time for the first diet update since I started this diet back up, and I decided to do it today as this is 31 days since I've started my diet back up again. And I know some of you have seen that I've got some bad news coming about my injury. I'm going to make a video about that a little bit later in the week, so I'm just going to focus on the diet right now and my progress so far. So let's go take a look at the spreadsheet.
This is the spreadsheet that I made for myself to go through and keep track of everything on my diet, and I wanted to show you guys a little bit about this. So I've got a measurement system, pound or kilograms, you can change that, and the official starting date of this diet was 8/15/2016, and I'm recording this on 9/15/2016, so a month later. Starting weight at 272, my goal weight is 230. My goal is to lose 2 pounds per week, and so you can see here, this is my BMR, base metabolic rate, and I used a couple different calculators to come up with that, and there were a bunch of TDEE estimates, so I kind of took the lowest one I found and the highest, went with the average, and to meet my goal, this is what I came up with. So I'm starting with a high estimate of 2,252 calories per day, trying to make sure that I am hitting at least 150 grams of protein and keeping my fat somewhere between 60 and 70 grams. And that's kind of what I'm doing. This daily tracking, every morning I weigh in. I weigh in at the same time. I wake up, I go to the bathroom, I weigh in. And this is my weight. This keeps track of what I've done. So you can see here I've lost 12 pounds. This is my projection based on the goal, and here's some formulas. And what I have here on the personal comments is information that I want to remember on why the weight might be off. So you can see my scale broke and I had to get a new scale. So that gave me a little bit of variance there. And then I had two birthday parties in a row, which caused some fluctuation. And based on Tony's Pure Fitness, he recommended weighing in on the evening as well. So these couple days I just estimated because I know I weighed in 275, but I've been keeping track of my evening weigh-ins right before bed as well, and I've lost about 11.8 pounds there, and I fluctuate on average 3.5 pounds between evening and morning weigh-ins, which is pretty interesting. And here we've got weekly progress, so it turns red if I weigh in more than the day before, and it just allows me to keep track on Monday, you know, Tuesday comparisons, and I've got it all graphed out here so I can see, you know, Monday weigh-ins. This is Monday to Monday. Been doing pretty good, nice downward trend, and you can see that every single day, week over week, I've been weighing in and going down. So that's pretty nice to see. This is the total progress. As you can see here, I've lost 12 pounds in total. My current weight, I weighed in at 260 pounds this morning. I've been on the diet for 31 days. I still have 30 pounds left to lose for my goal on January 1st. I've lost an average of 0.39 per day, which is about 2.71 per week. As this diet progresses, that's going to narrow down. At a certain point, I will have to lower my calories, and you can see here the graph on how I've done year over year. So this is where, you know, it gets discouraging when you see your weigh-in being higher the next day and, you know, high 2 days in a row, but this allows me to see, you know, what kind of trend I'm at and keep myself on task. This is a projection of my goal in the red line here, where I want to be by December 31st, January 1st, and you can see right now I'm beating my goal, so that's a nice thing to see. And I do have all of 2016. This is a different format, but you can see here on this tracking start to goal, I've shown that before, but in total it's 259 days of data from the beginning of the year. I've lost 22 pounds, so you can see I had 119 days where I lost weight, 104 when I gained, and 35 days where I weighed in the same from day to day. So this is kind of the progress over the year. And you can see this is just August. That's just a different graph than the green one that I showed you. And this was the original diet before I decided to bulk back up, where I actually lost 29.4 pounds in 117 days. Last thing that I want to show you on the spreadsheet is a diet comparison. I was really curious what would end up happening if I looked at my first diet, how long and how well I did starting at 272 pounds, which was about a month into the diet, versus this time. And you can see this blue line was the original diet, and I started at 272 and ended at 263 in the first 31 days from that 272. Whereas on the current diet, same starting spot, I'm losing weight better while eating more calories, and I ended at 260. So that's pretty interesting to see, and you can kind of see this is where I changed my workout days. So I've been working out Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday for a long time, switched it up to Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and you can see it kind of follows the same trend, but it pushed it all back a day once I changed that. So pretty interesting overall. Happy with the way progress has been going, and keeping track of this. If you want any information on the spreadsheet or want to see some more stuff, let me know.
And that is it for the diet update this time. Let me know in the next diet video what you guys want information about, what you want to see, what kind of you didn't care about, and I'm just overloading with information, because I really want some help and make sure that I stick to the diet this time. As I said, this is my only goal for the rest of the year and possibly the first couple of months of next year. And obviously with some of the injuries I have, I'm gonna have to work around that. But let me know what you guys wanna know. As always, go lift something heavy, and that is it for this update.